Yo, what it do? Super Nard off the Port with Dirty Glove Basket.
Super!
Calling my phone, text no reply. Got that bitch sending me peer. She y'all in the feelings and no one no dealing. Cut the little bitch on the pier.
Super Nard.
What it do, my boy?
Welcome to DGB, man. Thanks for being here today.
Salute.
Yeah, how you feeling today?
I feel good.
All right. And you're originally from Montgomery, correct?
Yeah, Montgomery, Alabama.
Yeah. What was it like growing up there? Was it really rough?
It's okay. It's rough. You know, you got different side of towns. You know what I'm saying? You got the south, the east, the west. All sides. It's a rough, but you know what I'm saying? It's like every other hood.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? A lot of snakes. Mm-hmm. A lot of, you know, a lot of goddamn everything going on down there.
Yeah. And you ended up playing college basketball, right?
Yeah, I played college basketball.
What school did you go to?
I went to a junior college in Panama City called Gulf Coast. Fucked around, got into it with the coach down there, went transferred to another junior college like Belva State. Went to, finished off at a school called Steelman in Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So why did you end up stop playing?
Shit, I really didn't stop playing. It was just, my time was up.
Yeah.
I could have went overseas, goddamn. I got offered a little contract overseas, probably like $4,000 a month or some shit like that. Just but shit, I was already, you know what I'm saying? I already had a little something going on in college. We were making more money than $4,000, so
yeah.
I was like, fuck it.
It wasn't worth it to travel overseas.
Yeah, no, not to be over there away from everybody.
Yeah, everything you know.
For 9 months, I don't see nobody. I'm like, hell no, I'll stay down here.
Yeah. So did you graduate college?
No, I ain't graduated. Okay. I ain't graduated. I stopped like the last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got you. All right. So who were some of your favorite rappers growing up?
My favorite rapper growing up was like T.I. was my favorite rapper growing up.
Why T.I.?
That trap music. That shit. That nigga, he had it. Yeah. He had the song back then. That trap music was motherfucker. I liked Jeezy, Gucci, Boosie, Plied back then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I fuck with them.
Yeah, a lot of street artists.
Street artists, yeah.
Yeah. All right, Ian. And you mentioned before that in other interviews that you had no intentions of rapping until Dope B got you into it, right?
I ain't never thought about rapping. I ain't never went to a studio.
Huh.
I ain't started going to a studio until I met Dope B.
Yeah.
And when he used to go in the booth, I ain't used to really go in the booth and pay attention. I used to, like, we'd probably be outside, bending on the 2K or some shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? When he come down here and work with Tip, now we in the other room playing 2K or betting on the game, some shit like that.
Yeah. All right, so even with him suggesting that you rap, why did you decide to give it a try?
Because, like, I would listen to all the other rappers, you know what I'm saying, where I was from, so I was doing everything that they were rapping about, like cars or the clothes, the jewelry, the trip. I was already doing it. I ain't spit a bar yet. So, like, man, dope, like, man. Him and Big Huck, that was his manager at the time. He's like, man, you got a story. People already love you, you know what I'm saying, for who you is. You make goddamn mind well speak to these people.
Mm-hmm.
So shit, I end up really like sneaking and doing a song one day by myself. I ain't want nobody to hear. I let Doe hear when we was in California.
Yeah.
That shit was suck. I can't lie, he bust out laughing.
He laughed.
But the next one I came with him, boy, he was like, boy, that's it.
Yeah.
You feel me? He was like, boy, that's it. Yeah, that was what it was doing.
Did you write that first song or did you freestyle it?
I wrote it.
You wrote it?
Yeah, pencil and pad.
Yeah.
It took me about goddamn a whole week to write that song. I can't lie. All right,
so after he laughed at that first song,
yeah.
Why'd you decide to try again? A lot of people probably would just would have gave up, you know?
Because I thought the song was hard.
Okay, okay.
He just thought it was, he thought this shit was whack. You feel me?
So you kind of want to prove him otherwise.
Yeah, then my other homeboy was like, well, that shit hard. You know, your homeboy don't want to let you down. They tell you anything. Yeah. Well, that shit hard. Why that shit? I can't lie. Yeah. All right,
I got you. And what's some of the best advice that Dobie gave
him? Advice from Dobie?
Mm-hmm. Whether it be about the rap game or.
Dobie ain't never really gave me no advice because I was older than him.
Okay.
But at the same time, I can probably like listen to him, his lyrics, listen to his music and
yeah.
Some shit that he's saying I probably went through or,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I can relate to it. That's how he can speak to me through his music, but he never really just gave me no advice
because
I was older than him.
Mm-hmm.
Feel me?
All right. I got you. And does it seem like he's been gone for 5 years now? Does it seem quicker or longer?
Time flies. It don't seem like it been no five. It don't seem like 5 years. Shit seem like yesterday.
Yeah.
For real, time flies.
Yeah.
It been 5 years. It seem like it been about a year or two. It don't seem that long. Still listen to his music every day. Still like you're here.
Mm-hmm. You think about him every day?
I'ma see something with him every day. It was a quote or picture or somebody, you know what I'm saying? You're a legend. So folks still showing love every day to him.
Yeah. What did he mean to Montgomery in Alabama?
Oh, he the GOAT.
Yeah.
He the GOAT in Alabama. He means so much to the community, to the city.
Mm-hmm.
Cause he was like, ain't nobody really never did. And then like, we got a couple people that got like some record deals and stuff like that, but it's different when you growing up or you around somebody and you seeing it instead of you like a kid and you see like Dirty Boys and Small Time. We kids, we really don't know, but we know they doing their thing, they got a deal, you know what I'm saying? But when you around your peers and you see him do it, it make a lot of folks dream big, like shit, it can happen, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. What did his death, how did his death affect Montgomery?
Shit, I feel like it fed in Montgomery in a bad way because like, just think about like, all the people it hurt, mm-hmm. all the people who were finna do this and do that, but the big dream, his dream got ended, so a lot of folk dream got ended. Like,
yeah.
Like what if something would have happened to like look at this, like Memphis. You get one big rapper, he can put a lot of big rappers on, he can put a lot of money in the community, the churches in the community, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Our rapper career got ended, so like it stopped a whole lot of, a lot of motion.
Yeah, and Doe definitely seemed like he wanted to put on for the city. Like,
Doe loved the city.
Yeah, and Junior Boss said the same thing. He encouraged him to.
He encouraged everybody who you probably seen doing it to do it and take it serious because we see that it really can happen.
Yeah.
Like it went from there to a brick. You feel me? Like shit, real.
Yeah. All right, so how did his death affect the music scene there in Montgomery, too?
Like I said, like, Doe was gonna put a lot of people on. He got a lot of people looking at Montgomery, Alabama,
yeah.
where they probably weren't looking at it like that. Like, we been getting overlooked,
mm-hmm.
but like, we had rappers that slipped through, but they big, too. We got greats now, like Dirty Boy, Small Time Baller, Duke Conrad, all them folks had deals and put on for the city as well. But Doja brought a whole nother, like, he bringing big folks to the city. Like, we got T.I.
Yeah.
We got T.I. in the neighborhoods down there, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He brought a lot of ambition, like, people want to do it because of what he did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, do you feel like his death is still felt in the music scene today? Like, have you guys recovered from his death?
Nah, not for real, because ain't nobody... I think you can't never say nobody gonna never be like Dope B, but it gonna be hard to get another Dope B.
Yeah.
The man was so hard.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, I'm in the studio, I just sit back and just look at him like, how the fuck that nigga just did that? Like, you feel me? Like, I ain't never seen nobody else do it like that.
On my phone, text no reply, got the bitch sending me peer. She y'all in the feelings and no one no dealing, cut the little bitch on the pier. All you heard was some shot and for real like dots, you would have thought they were peer. Don't come to my block if you fought with the odds, we do not.
You know what I'm saying, hard go, you know what I'm saying, you don't find too many niggas like that, man, cause the street cold, man. You don't find too many niggas who'll give a helping hand, give it last to him. If he know you a real nigga, he'll give you a
pass
lad.
That turkey for
you know what I'm saying? So. That man giving out turf for Thanksgiving and shit, you know what I'm saying? Nigga need, man. We in Montgomery, man. Niggas in the pros and shit, doing all type of shit, man. Nigga don't be coming back showing no love and shit. Nigga don't owe shit, but you know what I'm saying? Well, my partner, don't got everything he got out the mud. Everything he got. Everything he got.
We always been some good, hard ass niggas.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know why this shit had to happen now. But we gonna move on. We're gonna keep on going.
CBM to the death. You know what I'm saying? The music ain't gonna stop, cause boy, the boy got stuck in the library, man. This shit live on the K, man. Like, we just don't understand, live, man. This shit got so much history, man. But like, where we at right now, man? Like, shit, this shit right here should be in Montgomery. Like, this shit should be like in an Alabama motherfucking historical book. Or something,
for real,
man. For real, man. They made history right here, man. Nigga, they got harassed by the police. right here in front of their motherfucking grandma. Nigga, they had shootout right here. Motherfucking $100 dice game, better 100, shoot 100 right here. Everything, man. Nigga, they had tip. They came through here, the motherfucking Fabian Bentley, man. You know what I'm saying? Big homie, man. Don't be, man. The man was 22, a legend, man. I like this shit right here. Shout out to West End, bro. Hey, them boys blow, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? Chop Bridge Money Drop, we gonna be all up that bitch promote, man. We fuck with everybody who fuck with the campaign. Salute to everybody who take their time out to tweet, to even use the energy to say a nigga name on the internet to support. We really appreciate that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Shit, haters, we gonna let them niggas hate anyway, you feel me? They all niggas dick anyway. They ain't never seen a young nigga shine, especially like the legendary Dope B. Yeah, you speak Dope B now, and you down there speaking Martin Luther King in Alabama.
Gang hood rich, CPM gon' hold Dope B down forever.
Trad bag money.
Your legacy is infinite, homie. I know Brick, you hear me talking.
Diamond through checks daily.
Trash bag money, please don't get me started.
Racks.
Number racks off in this bag, this ain't no garbage. Shoebox money, please don't get me started.
My move.
Here to the top 100s, ain't no joke.
DJ Frank White.
Trash bag money, please don't get me started.
Racks.
Number racks off in this bag, this ain't no garbage.
Though, this shit ain't good, this shit ain't no echo, nothing. 100 mile per hour in these streets, though. I can't lie, man. Up on my Twitter, Instagram, CB on Pair, but you know what I'm saying? Better look out for that chopper bricks and money, the mid tape. You feel me? I guarantee that shit gonna touch the world, nigga.
The hustle, nigga. Y'all know I'm here, man.
Follow me on Twitter, DJ Joy334, bitch ass nigga. Bitch, I'm funny. Fucking with CBM, Frank White. Shout out to my niggas.
It's your boy DJ Frank White, the Alabama plug, man. Salute my homie Trey, man. Shout out to Dope B, CBM, Hustle Gang, man. In the building, the album coming soon. Be on the lookout. Hit me on Twitter at DJ Frank White.
Remix said, dang, this ain't never swag money. Swag. Mama said, boy, you act like you ain't never had nothing. Shirt man money, I don't talking cash money. And when I grow up, I wanna be a millionaire. Shoebox money, man, I got about 50 pair. Filled up with hundreds, ain't no 20s, ain't no 50s. And my clientele jumping, cause my 20s look like fishes. Sold a diamond to a diamond, then I cash out on a bricky. Remix, I brought a quarterback like Robert Griffin. Walking with them trash bags like I'm working for the city. Nigga, check that shoe, box them, ain't no motherfucking Timbaland.
Bitch,
counting all this damn money, man, my hand hurt.
Shit,
granddaddy perk, got my next tail chirping. Bring it to your front door, call it curb serving. Put me in the Hall of Fame, a young Joe Gerber.
Yes.
All this shit I sold, I should have been a pharmacist.
Whoa.
Just make sure your money's straight, or I can't front your shit. Ever seen a trap nigga do a magic trick?
Shit.
Mid with the strong, 18 to a 36.
Racks.
I got swiper sips, I'm Ridgecrest to the Harlem.
Stacks.
Nigga playing with that work, he gon' have problems.
Packs.
Nigga mad about his bitch because she swallowed.
Dump, 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 dump through situations where we call.
Unless your bitch come on in with my chair, scrape, bitch. More than that, nigga, you got the street, nigga. Fuck with that nigga, street, nigga. Especially when that chop breast and money come out, nigga. I guarantee we gonna shock the world, nigga. I guarantee that.
It'll be all over the damn globe.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, cause we got talent. Yeah.
You
gotta let them know.
They go, you know what I'm saying?
But
like,
do your research.
Do your research, livemixtape.com, man.
Definition of trouble, livemixtape.
Definition of trouble, one. Definition of trouble, two.
Trap life,
baby. Jesus, Pier Boy. Mo P on no credit, you know what I'm saying? This shit came from nothing, man. We ain't had shit, man.
Trap Bricks,
we ain't had shit, my nigga.
Trap 3 on the way.
You know what I'm saying? This shit still coming, nigga. They gonna come with that bag, though.
We ain't letting up.
They gonna come with that bag.
And we look like we ain't got nothing right now.
And I tell everybody, man, you know, what is CBM, who in it, you know what I'm saying, and what's CBM all about?
CBM. See them in Coke Block movies.
Yeah.
What is it about?
Gonna stop?
What is it about? That's another one.
Gonna stop?
What is it about?
Stop, you feel me? You know what I mean? My bad to introduce y'all, you know what I'm saying? For the
CBM
you know
is
the
about money.
Right here. But I got to introduce the Gunna Star, did the star, you feel me?
Salute.
A real CBM Coke Block nigga, you feel me?
Hello, boss.
Huh? You know what I'm saying? It's raw right here, you know what I'm saying? You know, it is what it is. Y'all can chop that up or whatever. That way, that had to go put a real nigga on it. You feel me? That's what it is. I be fucking with street niggas and shit, though. Like, I ain't with all that industry. No industry shit, dog. Period. No industry shit, period.
I fuck with Coke,
you know what I'm saying? I ain't got no disrespect to the industry, you know what I'm saying? But shit, I'm a street nigga, you know what I'm saying? Y'all come to me with that shit. You already know, man, got to come with a bag, because with the choppers and money drop, man, this shit finna get real hectic, man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't really been reaching out to nobody like that, you know what I'm saying? Not shit, you know what I mean? Because no beat, you know what I'm saying? We still working on choppers and money. Choppers and money finna change the world, man. I ain't like my partner. He still here. Like, when y'all hit his new music,
I like the work
out,
a lot
you
know of these niggas out here, though.
You feel me? I fuck with any real nigga, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I fuck with real nigga,
Metro
man.
Metro Boomin'. You feel me?
You know what I'm saying?
Any hood nigga, any street nigga. They
reach out,
fuck with
you
nigga.
Down.
You feel me? Fuck with
you
nigga.
Yeah,
fuck with nigga who real shit. Too gone.
Fuck with nigga, if you real.
Like, got it.
Real niggas, man.
That was it,
I like to fuck with a lot of these niggas though, but shit, it is what it is. I'm fucking with my
fuck
niggas.
Fuck about the fine though. A nigga got money. Nigga living a real life, you know what I'm saying? Nigga got churn and shit, you know what I'm saying? It's all about keeping that shit solid, bill 100 and standing for something, my nigga.
You feel me?
We young nigga, we stand for something, you know what I'm saying? That's what it is. Mm-hmm. If you stand for something, my nigga, and you about your, and you handle your business, shit, salute you, we'll fuck with you, you feel me? All the unnecessary shit, bullshit, nigga, all that dumb ass shit, you know what I'm saying? Hating ass shit, we don't fuck with you. Fuck Black Peter, fuck you, you know what I'm saying? CBM, man. That was it. I ain't gonna lie to you, that Birmingham shit, them boys got gas, no break.
Y'all know something?
You know what I'm saying? For real, from Dirt to Diamond, man. Young black man, self-made, you know what I'm saying? Though I say you ain't gonna never find no clip like her, man. You ain't gonna never find no young nigga like her, man. For real, cause we really live this shit, man. We down south, man, Montgomery, Alabama, man. It's hard for a black nigga down here, you know what I'm saying? Look what my partner did, look what my brother did. You know what I'm saying? Shit, crowds in the bucket down here, but we still finna. We got some big boy shit planned for a nigga, you know what I'm saying? So that's what it is, and that's how it gonna be. It's CBM to the death for all my niggas, you know what I'm saying? Every nigga live that.